Hello friends, welcome to this exciting course on Internet of Things by Wishtree. If you are a beginner, if you are a student, or if you are a professional, then this is a perfect place for you to begin your journey with IoT. I'm your coach Pratibham Dwivedi. I have 10 years of software industry experience where I have worked with multiple multinational companies. I primarily focus on emerging technologies like IoT, Raspberry Pi, AWS, SAP and Azure. This course is accompanied with this Wishtree kit, which is IoT Bees. So if you haven't purchased it so far, go ahead and purchase this because our projects will be based on the components in this kit. This course is all about learning electronics and introduction to IoT. So if you have no prior experience with electronics or all these things, then I promise you, you are at the right place. Before we dive into the course details, let's first understand what is IoT and what are the benefits of IoT. Internet of Things basically defines the network of things, where things are the physical objects that are embedded with sensors, softwares and other technologies for the purpose of communicating data from one thing to other things or the different systems over the internet. So that was a technical definition of Internet of Things. Let's understand it in a very simple layman terms. So for example, you have things around you, like for example, chairs in your class. So let's say you want to know how many chairs are occupied in a class at a given time. How would you do that? One way is you just put some sensors in the chairs and you can then connect those chairs to the internet. Now, whenever the chair is occupied, your systems will know because the chair is telling to your system that there's somebody sitting on that place. So what you have done is you have made your chair a smart chair by connecting it to internet, right? So let's understand the benefits of IoT and why should you learn it. In real world scenarios, you can collect data, apply data and analytics, and thereafter take some actions based on the data. So let's take an example of geyser. You switch on the geyser every day, right? So what you can do is you can make the geyser smart and it will switch on at a designated time, let's say. This technology is being used a lot by businesses and hence there is a huge demand for IoT engineers who understand these concepts and can build new systems around it. There are advanced concepts like smart factory, which is coming up. They are all based on IoT. What they do is they apply sensors onto their existing machineries, gain data insights on it, and can do predictive maintenance as well to improve efficiency and reduce operational costs. These are also acting as new business models for startups. Now, before we really start the course, let's take a few minutes to know what's included in the course and how is it going to work.
There is a plethora of knowledge in this course, and these are the topics that we would be covering. We are keeping in mind that you are a beginner and have very little or no knowledge about electronics. So we'll be looking at every component and basic details that is required to get started. Firstly, in this chapter, we saw what is IoT and why should you learn it. In the next one, we'll unbox the Wishtree kit and look at each and every component at a very high level. Thereafter, we'll jump into a bit of details about what are ICs, what different type of ICs are there, what is a microcontroller, what are modules, and other sensors and things like that, which are very commonly used in almost all the IoT projects. From chapter number 4, we'll start getting into Arduino platform and Arduino Uno as a hardware open source platform. In chapter number 5, we'll install Arduino IDE. And from there on, we'll move to basic coding of Arduino. We'll learn about the Blink program, which is the Hello World program in Arduino world. And from chapter number 8, we'll get into understanding the sensors and signals using projects. In the last chapter, we will have an exciting project where you will be using all that you learned throughout this course.
There are a few points that I would request you to keep in mind while taking up this course.
always code and build along with us. This way, you will grasp the concepts really well. There are coding challenges and build challenges along the way. I would also request that you pause the videos at that point and take those challenges. When you think on your own, then that's the best way of learning. Also, take notes. Writing down key concepts would make it really easy for you to refer them at later stages. I would also recommend that you take the entire course, though you can skip a few topics that you think you already know.
By the end of this course, you will have good understanding of electronics, Arduino, programming part of it, and also some sensors and common actuators. And you will also be able to build your own simple projects. So finally, let's get started.